Hello, hello, good morning. Is this still morning? I don't know. And this is Chemistry 369. Today we're gonna have a qualitative analysis. Let's check it out. Let's go inside. Let's go. Where is the key? I lost the key. All right. So I have seen many good technique from qualitative analysis.
Alright guys, so don't forget to subscribe and put the notification button on.
Subscribe!
And today we're gonna discuss about experiments about qualitative analysis. Let's check it out. Let's go inside. Okay, I have seen many good qualitative analysis technique from students who take the AS practical exam. However, most of the technique are not in the textbook. So I'm going to tell you the technique that actually worked. Welcome to our lab. So today we're gonna have a qualitative analysis. We have these three ions to detect. We have zinc 2 plus, we have ammonium and H4 plus, and then we have nitrates and O3 minus. So now we're going to detect the presence of the cations. Zinc 2 plus. But the big question is how to get the samples, how many drops or how many, what is the quickest way to take samples? Okay, the quickest way is that just use one squeeze of the pipe, one zip of the pipette. If you wanna measure 20 drops, it's okay. Qualitative analysis, as long as you do it consistent, that's still okay. Let's go here. So I have 1 centimeter depth with approximately 1 zip of the pipette. So every time there is 1 centimeter depth writing in the paper, I'm going to measure it 1 zip of from the pipette. Okay. And then I want to detect it with sodium hydroxide because I know that zinc 2 plus will react with sodium hydroxide. But how many we should put an OH into zinc 2 plus? So the basic agreement is you put the reagents 2 or 3 drop first, do not shake like that, and then you put excess, then you can shake. Yeah, there is a white PPT starting to produce. So the first 2 drops do not shake. Just observe the white PPT over there. Okay, the next step, you put excess of the reagents. Our reagent is sodium hydroxide. So how many, what is excess? If I use 1 centimeter depth of the samples, I should use thrice or double the volume of the initial samples. Okay, here I use 4 times of the initial ratio from the samples, and then we start to shake. As you can see, the PPT already dissolved, so you should write down the PPT dissolved or soluble in excess reagents. For the next test, we're gonna test the presence of ammonium in these samples. I've already put 1 centimeter depth of ammonium in this our test tube over here. So you're gonna try to push ammonia from this, so you're going to use sodium hydroxide as our reagents. You're gonna put excess, put it over here, and then prepare a red damp litmus paper. So how to damp a litmus paper? You just put water onto the litmus paper. Okay, so I'm going to put sodium hydroxide into ammonium solution over here. So you're gonna write down a gas produced, and the gas turns the red damp litmus paper into blue. That's what you write. So write. Do not write a basic gas produced, because basic, you have to make a conclusion. Conclusion is not observation. So be careful when you write down. All right. So lit off fire, and we are done. Guys, so the next one is to detect the presence of nitrates, NO3 minus ions, in the solution. How to do that? So you need a reducing agent, you need aluminum foil. And then you need a basic solution, very strong sodium hydroxide. Make sure the sodium hydroxide is in excess. So you have a mixture of nitrates, of samples, and then aluminum foil, and then sodium hydroxide. Now the process that the reduction happened, and then the gas of ammonia will produce. So we're going to detect the presence of nitrates based on the production of ammonia. So I will need a damp red litmus paper again. Put like that, very neat. Okay, so I'm going to heat it, turn into blue. So what I should write in the column of observations, there are three. One is the bubbles of gas produced, and then the aluminum turns black, being consumed, and then the damp litmus paper from red change into blue. So there's three marks for observation for testing nitrates ions. Okay, so today we have already detected three ions. We have detected zinc 2 plus, we have detected nitrates, we have detected ammonium. Okay, so if you still have any questions, just put in the link comment below, or just ask me. Yeah. Okay, cheerio, goodbye. I'm going to clean this up. Bye bye.